Welcome to the Swaylax Stadium in Cardiff, home of Glamorgan County Cricket Club. In the show today, we'll be going behind the scenes and also we'll be talking to international cricketer Robert Croft. As another Ashes series has crept up on us, we'll be chatting to Marcus and Robert and finding out their opinions on the games and also their predictions. We'll be taking a look back at my career and, of course, there's the LV Challenges.
It's my pleasure to introduce Robert Croft, a Welsh sporting great. Robert, how have you found the transition from being a player to a coach?
Well, just standing here is a bit difficult. It's been quite easy actually, Simon, because you know my age, I'm 43, and a lot of the players in the dressing room were younger than me, and so I was like a father figure anyway to them. So stepping back and stepping into the coaching environment hasn't been tricky for me.
Looking back at the career which spanned, 25 years?
Yeah.
Any memories that really stand out for you?
Well, it'd be very difficult to throw them up here just like that. I mean, you always sort of remember your debut, don't you, in Glamorgan colours, which is in 1989. My debut in Glamorgan second team colours was in 1986. England debuts 96 at the Oval. And then you remember, which has been great for me, is that a lot of what you're judged on your career is show us your medals. And I've been very, very fortunate to have been part of Glamorgan sides that have won things. Yeah. When you win things with your mates around you, it's pretty special, isn't it? Yeah.
You played for many years for Glamorgan. Mm. You've played in many squads, many teams. How do you judge this squad at the moment?
In one-day cricket, good. In championship cricket, not quite so good. I do believe that the talent that we have in our team right now, particularly our first team, it's got experience, it's played all around the world, it's played in teams that have won things. So, yeah, if you're asking me what the expectancy of this team was at the start of the season, I would say quite high. Where we're at in four-day cricket, I don't think we've got to how we'd expect to have performed. Yeah. However, in one-day cricket, I think we're there so far at this stage in this season. We've played three 2020 games, we've won the three of them. You know, we're in the mix of the 40-over competition as well. Championship cricket, we're halfway through the season. We've only won one game, so we're not quite where we'd like to be. But we're all talking about if we can get four or five wins going, then you just never know, and get you back in the park and we'll have
nice,
a chance.
Yeah. Right, Rob, thanks so much for your time. Cheers, I know you're a busy man now that you're in the coaching staff and I really appreciate it.
Cheers, mate.
Thank you.
See you, pal.
Hi there. We're in the indoor school at the Swaylax, ready for the LVC challenges. Unfortunately, the physio's pulled me out of the challenges as I've hurt my AC joint in my left shoulder, but I'm very excited to introduce Chris Cook, who is a young, hard-hitting batsman from Glamorgan, and I like to call him Sport Billy because he's very good at all sports. Come in, please, Chris.
Hi.
Are you excited about today?
Very excited, yeah. Buzzing.
The first game is called Pull the Other One. Come on, Chris. Ah! That's a good start.
10 or 3. Come on.
Oh! No!
Found the gap, bro.
Found the gap.
Yeah.
It's in my blood. My dad played before me. He played for Glamorgan. Now, sadly, his career finished when he was 26. But obviously, he played for England as well. So I think it's obviously in your family. So that's what you grow up playing. I played a lot of football when I was younger, but cricket took over as I got older and bigger. The Ashes 05. Obviously, we were chatting earlier with some of the lads, and it's the biggest thing you can play in, the biggest competition in the world. And for me to be part of that after the setbacks I'd had was special in itself. It's huge because obviously it's the biggest series in world cricket, the history that's behind it. Everything that is the Ashes is awesome, and you know, in 2005 English cricket was going really well. In the 4 years previous to that, we'd beaten every other team, and I think the Ashes series in 2005 put cricket back on the map in Britain. And you look at the team now, they're doing so well and they're dominating world cricket.
This next game is called Safe Hands.
Not a catch.
Red basket.
Yeah.
I hit him in the sleeve.
You got really awesome, didn't you?
There's got to be 40 or 50 in there. All right, let's count them up, Chris. 1, 2. 9, 3, 3, 1, 2, 3, 3, 3. 5, 6, 7, 8, 8, 9. One more, come on, 50. 50, 51, 52. 52 balls, that's like a serious effort.
New champ.
Awesome, well done.
I have been asked to give you a tour of the ground and all the important places on the ground. This is the CC4 Welsh Museum Cricket Room. So if you come with me, I'll take you around. You know, things can easily be forgotten. And for the history of the club, being a Welsh team, we're the only Welsh county as the other 17 are English. So I think it's really important as a Welsh team that we keep our identity.
Well, that's a good move.
It's nice seeing yourself as a right-hander when you're left-handed. Oh, that's four.
It looks like me a bit, doesn't it? They've got grey hair as well.
Hello guys, this is the indoor school that we use during the winter months. The space that we have in here is brilliant because we can do our fitness work in here. We can do our cricket work, and it's a very versatile space. This ground now is as good as any, I reckon, in regards to facilities for the supporters. And she's very busy, which is obviously a great sign for the club. Right, if you obviously scan her on the ground now, you can see what an impressive place it is. When I first started in 1996, the old pavilion was where the Foster Stand is. And this ground is so impressive now. It's you know, something to behold for someone like myself, starting here so young, and then just seeing it grow and develop as a ground and become a test ground. Obviously now we're in the media centre. You know, you look at the view we've got here, it's really impressive, and that's a perfect place to watch cricket really. Obviously you've got the rows and rows and rows of seats for, you know, the different channels covering the game, and to be fair, it's a pretty nice place to work, I reckon. There's far worse places that you could be. You okay? Right. We're now on the second floor. This is where all the playing staff are. Yeah, but if you look at where the umpires are, this is very comfortable indeed. They've got loads of room to themselves. It's nice and cool on the warm days. And they get looked after really, really well. And if you look, we've got some of the ex-players on the wall. We've got Michael Kasparovic, absolute legend and man. An absolute gentleman and an absolute quality cricketer. There's a nice little one of myself there. It's faded slightly because of the sun, but there's obviously one here of a real Glamorgan legend. You know, you look at Crofty's stats, he's got 1,000 wickets and over 11,500 runs. That's a career to really be proud of. And, you know, I was lucky enough to play with him for a few years, and I really enjoyed playing with him and learning the game from him as well. Right, this next game is called Hawkeye.
Come on, Cookie. Close me, pal, come on. Ooh! Oh. Decent gas.
Good place.
Come on, Cookie boy, close me. Oh, lucky.
What do you reckon?
Reach out a bit more.
Reach out a bit more, yeah.
Come on, Cookie. Come on, fella, come close me. Yes, Cookie. Ah, oh, no! That's the... Why? Close me, pal, close me. Come on. Oh! Oh! Two left, come on, fella. Leave the front arm off. Come on, Cookie. Yes, Cookie. Oh, unlucky.
It's not a bad length. It's
a good line and length.
Yeah, it's a good four-day length.
Last one.
Last
come
one.
On, make it count.
Okay.
Yes, Cookie, come on. Yes!
Yeah!
The minute you let that go, I knew it was there.
Right, that's the end of the challenges. Nico, unlucky.
young Chris Cook is the top of the table. It just leaves it for next week now with Marcus Piszkowiak to try and beat that, but I can't see that happening, if I'm honest. I know I helped him slightly, but he's done real well today. You can also film your own challenges and send them to the Twitter address of LV County Catchup. We'll also include the best in the next show. Chris Cook, he's a superb athlete and he's got the quickest hands I've ever seen in any batter. The joke guy, Dean Crossgrove's got to be up there. He's always up to mischief and he enjoys seeing other people struggling sometimes. I'd have to be up there. I'm not really the easiest to talk to sometimes. I've been dealing with lots of rehabs, so it can be quite hard to be around sometimes. So that's a lot for this show. I hope you enjoyed. For more behind the scenes content, contact ecb.co.uk/LVCC. And for all you Twitter users, contact #LVCountyCatchup. In the next show, we're down at Somerset with Marcus Piszkowiak. He's going to take us behind the scenes down there and show us why they've been so successful. I'm Simon Jones, and thanks for watching.